you are a victim yourself.
Yes.
And nothing happened to the president of the trade so far.
But you've done an application to IG, which I'm going to speak to IG.
Mr. President, sir, may we know some of the details of your discussion with you, sir?
Yeah, well, thank you very much. I've not been here for quite some time. So first it was to appreciate the president's leadership and to reassure him of my absolute loyalty, which is unconditional. Whether I am chairman, I'm not chairman. The most important thing is I am a loyal member of the All Progressive Congress. And I will always do everything I can to support the growth and development of the party. And of course, my absolute loyalty to the president as a person and to the government that he leads. The second was to have opportunity to give an update on what we are doing in Edo, and the campaigns are going well. The level of massive support is huge, and from my evaluation, share with him, I'm very confident that we will win the election hands down. There's no question about that, because Edo is basically APC state, and some of the things that have made our campaign easier is the fact that we've established a tradition in Edo state that don't believe any politician until you have seen the action, particularly if that politician is already in office. If he's not yet in office, you can have a way to ask yourself, should I believe this one? If there are two strangers, who should you believe? It can be quite challenging. But when you have an incumbent governor who is being challenged by someone who has not yet been a governor, the issue is simple. In your ward, and we have 192 wards, we go out to ask them just one question. Have you seen government presence in this ward since 4 years ago when I left? And the answer is no. Because the current governor spent all his time on memorandum of understanding for refinery, which remains a memorandum, it's not on ground. He got our vice president, Yemi Osinbajo, to come and do groundbreaking for an industrial park where he claimed that many Chinese and Singaporeans were anxious to come and relocate factories, and we create 200,000 jobs. Now that place has become kidnapper's park, because people rob and go into the bush. There is nothing going on there. Not that the progress is slow, absolutely nothing going on there. And of course, the Gilligilli port, all of the promises he made with IOU, they are lavishly used on television, white men, colored people signing agreement, etc. People now say 4 years later, none of them is in progress. And he has not built schools, though is the main industry in Edo is education. People are very cautious of education, which was why during my tenure, we made it a policy to renew public schools, primary, secondary. And in his time, he has collected the money from Suburb, but he has used them for other purposes. So we're asking the people, in your ward, have you seen new red roof? Because that is how they could name the schools we were building. Because we used lock span aluminum and casement windows, aluminum windows. And word by word, they can't point at anything that is new. Then we ask them, has he constructed road in your local government? The answer is no. In fact, in one community he visited day before yesterday, the traditional ruler asked him, there was this road, not more than 5 kilometers, linking the community to another community that will enable them to evacuate their farm produce to the market. And he said, since comrade left, you promised when you came here with comrade, comrade said you will continue with the road project. But since he left, you have abandoned it. And he said, oh, I was distracted. But if I'm re-elected, I will do it. And people are like, when you knew you would seek re-election, you didn't do it. You were not afraid. when we have given you final term, what are our options? Should you not do it? So you just find that MOUs are only celebrated by consultants. They are not celebrated by real people. And you can hire 1 million social media people to post all kinds of negative stories. They do not change the fact of what is on ground. And the actual voters, they are not social media warriors. They just look at the environment and say, do I now have water? The last time a borehole was sunk in this community was during Oshiohmole. Even now, the borehole is not being maintained, so it has broken down. And this government is not doing anything. So our campaign is so easy. And I'm sure if you watch the visuals on the social media, you see the reaction of people when we go for campaign. It's not just about the number of people that turned up. You see the energy, the excitement, the passion that people are in a hurry to vote for APC. So I share all of this with Mr. President. And lastly, to say that the outgoing governor is talking more about violence, violence, violence. You must have watched him on Channel Television where he said he will meet violence for violence. And we are saying, no, there will be no violence. It will be like a celebrity Christmas. Or you are going to do a plebiscite between MOU, which Edo people has now codenamed a memorandum of underdevelopment, and a governor with a clear, simple agenda, which is the product of his brain. And you will have noticed that we've changed our campaign strategy too. In 2016, I was the one doing the talking, explaining that the governor will continue building schools, he will continue infrastructure, he will continue erosion control, he will continue with rural, urban roads, etc. But this time, our candidate is familiar with the environment, he's been in the state all his life, so he knows the challenges, and it takes time to explain what he calls a simple agenda. So mine is just to say why we should trust him, and why we cannot trust the other one. And that is easy to explain, because he abandoned the promise of continuing with the projects that made us the darling of Edo people. So I shared this with Mr. President, and I said, all we just need is good security. If APC man commit an offense, arrest him. If a PDP man commit an offense, arrest him. Once, it is not about sermon. Sermon do not change the heart of the devil. What changed the heart of man is the fear of sanction. And once one person is arrested from APC, another person is arrested from PDP if they are found involved in unlawful possession of firearms and they misuse those firearms and they are arrested and prosecuted, the message is clear. Of course, you saw the governor, again, not me now, don't take it from me. You saw the governor saying he and his deputy, they have immunity and therefore they could do and undo. That's true, they have immunity. But it is also clear that the talks they used to carry unlawful firearms, as they did 3 days ago when they got to a community and they found that there was no crowd, they have to use firearms to generate confusion and even went to seize the telephone of the area commander and assistant commissioner of police who was there along with other DPOs to provide security for their rally. But nobody turned up for the rally because that is the area we have built network of roads, schools, give them electricity. And those guys will not forget us in a hurry. So that is what you see when I get to a crowd and you see the reaction. And people are like, no. So the challenge, our mission is simple. Do you want to get a second chance for somebody who has confessed to failing primary school? Should you promote him to secondary school? The answer is no. So I have a duty to brief the president, not as chairman, let me be emphatic, but as a member, a loyal member of APC who has had the privilege of being a governor twice and has had the privilege of being a national chairman for 2 years. It was a lovely meeting, and the president was happy with the briefing. All we just need is security, and everything will be fine. Well, President's reaction is clear. If you are, he's the president of Nigeria, he's also the leader of our party. And I briefed him on what is happening. You know, his attitude is always clear, that Nigeria electorate, their right must always be respected. And anybody using unlawful weapon, violence, to intimidate the electorate, the president will never support such causes. And on that, we are together. And I ask you, forget about the fact that I'm pursuing a partisan agenda, but as Labour, police couple of times shot and killed some of my supporters. I never asked them to go after the police. And I have run election as governor in Edo 3 times, and there was no violence. So what has changed now that people are suddenly talking of violence? The people are still the same. The only thing that has changed is who is the governor, who boasts of his immunity, et cetera, et cetera. So president is excited at the prospect of having a free and fair election devoid of violence. And the fact that the laws are clear, when people misuse firearms, the laws are clear as to what should be done. Namely, the courts are there, the police are there, and they will do their job. It doesn't matter which party anybody belongs, the laws are the same. As for the judgment in Bayelsa, you know, these are matters for learned people. What is clear is that the tribunal has avoided the election. The implication for that, for my party, is something that we need, or we as a party, we will seek legal opinion. What does that mean for us?